Hi, I'm David. Excuse me, David Crazy Rides. And, hold on a second, let me go back to the entrance for a minute. This is a new version of Lost Kingdom. I had to redo it all, because I lost all my work. As you can see, it's different this time. This is Lost Kingdom, which is my theme park, and this is Let's Play Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. As you can see, this is the entrance. This is Lost Kingdom Street, which is only a short little area with the haunted house and 3D cinema, as you can see. Done a lot of work. There's a bit of the monorail for the guests. And when you hit this wall of China, well, bit of wall of China, is Forbidden Valley, which is from all the way around that little mountain to Forbidden Train. Just, and then you got like Kingdom Mouse at the back of where the cap, you know, the Wall of China is. You go through it. Sorry. As you can see, I made this. The reason why it's called Kingdom Mouse 2, it was originally a wooden one that was here, but I redesigned it with a better version of it. As you can see, it's all white and that. Give you a little time to actually watch it properly. I've done quite a number of rides. This is, it's like a family type ride that I've created, you know. Whereas rides like Zoinks, which is base of Worf, you know what Shaggy says from Scooby-Doo, you know, Zoinks, which is based on, which you would be seeing Zoinks throughout the ride, double looping, giant loops. You go through a barrel roll, and there's a hidden compartment where the square is, which is, that's what it does. Oh, here comes the train. Whee. Now, can you imagine riding that? I didn't want to make the ride too long. I didn't want to make it too short either, being, you know, a little small, little dinky little area like that. And this, guys, is not the Nemesis from Orson Towers. I recreated my own little version. bit inventive, really, when you think about it. I'm gonna turn it around a bit, actually. Make it that way. This is something that I wanted to create, something completely different. This goes around like a bit of a mountain and has giant loops in it, but it doesn't go through barrel rolls. The only reason why it doesn't do that is because every time I try to create a barrel roll, it comes up with extreme high all the time, so, and I don't want to make it too extreme. As you can see, I'm just following it through. or through a corkscrew like that. As you can see, it's like picking up speed, ready to go through the big giant loops. As you can see, right down we go. And block breaks. It took me ages to build this. Try and make it not too extreme, like, you know? To the station. That's nothing really, a nemesis. Well, it is, but I've created other rides. That's a family ride, the Forbidden Train. You can obviously see what goes on there. I've got monster trucks. There's Sky Ride. It's my own little version of. Well, it's the same design as Colossus, but there's a little bit of difference to it, really, if you... No, that's not it. Because if you look here, there's a photo spot. Whereas with the Six Flags design, you don't get that, so I copied the design and created my own. But this is called Robin Hood and Green Arrow, which is obviously a thrill-seeking wooden roller coaster, white knuckle coaster, whereas Air of Flight isn't. Yeah, I've built it more of a family ride. I know it looks like it's not, but it is. It's not dead fast. It's just you're supposed to enjoy the ride more. For for people that's never, been on big roller coasters, it's like a step up really. And then there's Golf Center and all that. And all the little shops and that. This bit is where Sphinx is. I've closed it off, the same as my own version of Splash Mountain. I'm going to recreate my a new ride, which I want to build a new coaster, and they call Sphinx 2. Be rerouting Splash Mountain, make it different. That's all I can tell you. But now I'm gonna give you a little ride of Sphinx. Before I do anything. Well, Splash Mountain goes up a big mountain that I've created. I'm telling you now, it wasn't exactly cheap to do, actually. Two loops. As you can see, it goes round a mountain fully. You see, this was a before I created the Nemesis, the looping coaster. Whereas the Nemesis doesn't go around the mountain fully like that, where it just turns and goes around it just once, like that. Nemesis goes around the mountain, but it's like it's going to pick up speed ready for the big giant loops, whereas there's only small loops on this one. There's like four loops on the Sphinx ride. I'll show you the hidden ones, which is here, the purple box hidden there. Reason why it is dead big is because there's a an Egyptian Sphinx right where this sand thing is. I know you can't see it very well, being, you know, and that. I'll show you in a minute, because I'm getting rid of this ride anyway, as you can see. Anyway, this is Water Valley area. I forgot to tell you, because you're in. Because you come out of Forbidden Valley, which is where this bit of the castle, because you come out from Kingdom Street into Forbidden Valley, and you walk up here, it's like Water Valley. You've got all these other rides here. Quite a little good little amusement park, don't you think? That's what I mean by Splash Mountain going up here. Mountain and you just dip right down there. This part here, this yellow where the squares are, the 3D squares, you turn around and start going backwards, and you don't turn back around going forwards until around this other Sphinx here. There, you go back to normal here, along there. Let's see. Now, this is prehistoric land. Well, obviously, because mind you, you might have thought it was Jurassic Park, but it's not, it's prehistoric land. With all the prehistoric, you know, dinosaurs. We've got a helicopter ride, tree choppers. This is T-Rex by Corkscrew. Yeah, and cold screws. That's T-Rex. See it from the back. Sorry, I need to take that off. See, this blue ride is called the Dragon. It's, you know, the blue track that you see. Let's see. There's your corkscrew round about there. As you can see, it's called the Dragon. That's the Dragon. And the Dragon comes all the way up here, and it's a 200 feet drop. It goes up to 200 feet and it drops from there. There's about four carts on this because it's a block break, so it goes through at least about five block breaks, but there's four carts. No, four trains. It took me a while to work this one, meaning, you know, with four carts and all the stops and everything, you know. Yeah. It's called the Dragon for obvious reasons, you know. Being prehistoric, you think. Well, I'd just put a bit of a myth type thing, because dragons are myths. But they are based on, you know, dinosaurs. And that is the Dragon. A bit of a Dragon Cafe. Jurassic Splash, which is this rubber dinghy ride here that I've created. A bit of fun. Ripsaw. There's dinosaur eggs, and this, my friends, is Racosaurus. I never created Racosaurus. I just thought it would look, you know, great as a family style ride. It's something that was already pre-built on Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. I created the other rides. Like, you know, Jurassic Splash, the Dragon and T-Rex and Prehistoric Castle, which is a dinosaur, you know, type. You know, it's like a ghost train really, but dinosaurs. So that, there's the raptor, the thing that's going upside down here. You know, when I created all the others, like from Sphinx, the Splash Mountain, Robin Hood and all that, and Green Arrow and Aerofly, all them, and I've created Forbidden Train, Kingdom Mouse 2, the Nemesis, and I created Zoinks. I created this little thing here called Forbidden Drop. There we are, Forbidden Drop. So that's my theme park, Lost Kingdom, hence different little sections like valleys and lands. Kingdom Street, which is only a little small little area. It's got its own little gift shop here. There's gift shop, little mini gift shops around, even Forbidden Valley. It's got its own little gift shop. And so the prehistoric land, which has got a prehistoric gift shop. You know, these little buildings have food and all that. And that's Water Valley gift shop here. So, this is Lost Kingdom. Hope you found it interesting. I'll be back with new updates. And, I hope to, get Planet Coaster properly working, because that, my friends, keeps crashing. It's my graphic drivers, they need updating properly. Everything else works, barring Planet Coaster. That's the only thing that could think that there's something wrong with the drivers. But anyway, or anywho, I can't wait to get to properly play Planet Coaster. All I can get up to at the moment is to design my own avatar on there, and I can't play the physical part of the game at the moment because it keeps crashing, like I say. That's the only part that keeps crashing. At the moment I'm playing Roller Coaster Tycoon 2. I can play Roller Coaster Tycoon 3, but all those saved games haven't been converted over to the PC yet, so we'll see. And because all those saved games are on another drive at the moment, because I had my PC updated, the only thing that never that needs a bit of an update is the high, you know, the graphics, you know, drivers or whatever they call it. That's the only thing that needs doing properly. Anyway, thanks for watching.